thanks for the opportunity to present to you our story this morning. It's a very exciting company doing some important things in cancer care. If I can have the next slide, please. And just skipping over the disclaimer slide. So this is just a high-level snapshot of the company. We are primarily a cancer-focused company, although we made an acquisition last year in the rare diseases space, which I'll talk a little bit about later in my presentation. I'll go through the details of how our technology works in a minute, but our primary focus in terms of cancer care is three areas: prostate cancer, renal or kidney cancers, as more generally known, and glioblastoma, which is a type of aggressive brain cancer. We had a very interesting year last year. Like a lot of biotech companies, a pandemic environment is not the greatest environment to do product development, but we still managed to conduct clinical work around the globe. Our perhaps most notable achievement last year was we succeeded in filing our first flagship product, which is called Illuccix. It's a product for the imaging of prostate cancer with 16 regulators around the globe. And I'll talk more about the progress of those regulatory approvals in a minute. But the key message I think I'd like you to get across today is we are one of the rare ASX-listed companies in the life sciences space that is now transitioning to a product stage revenue generating company. And so it's an extremely exciting time to engage with us and to understand what we're doing. We also acquired a production facility last year. Again, not an easy thing to do in a pandemic, but it's a project that we've been working on for about 18 months. In some parts of the world, we work with distributors to get our products out the door. In some parts of the world, we are a vertically integrated pharmaceutical company, so we have our own manufacturing capacity. So that was a very important acquisition for the company. Late last year, we entered into a strategic partnership with China Grand Pharma. This is a company that's well known to many Australian investors through the acquisition of Sirtex a couple of years ago. And that company is going to be a very powerful and useful partner for us in that key market. And it delivers quite a lot of long-term financial benefit to Telix, as well as the strategic partnership. And you know, many other partnerships and collaborations in progress. At the end of the presentation, I'm going to loop back around and talk about our major inflection points for this year. But I think just in a nutshell, we are in the process of launching our first product. We have a second product that will start the regulatory approval process at the end of this year. And then we're just in the process of kicking off a very significant phase three global therapeutics trial for our prostate cancer therapy program. And these three major inflection points will define the company over the next 12 to 18 months. Next slide, please. Just a quick snapshot about the company's financial performance. We are a well-funded company through a mixture of equity-based placement and investment from the market, as well as some strategic financing, as I mentioned before. We have adequate cash on hand to run our clinical activities until around about the middle of next year. Not counting in the impact of our revenue generation from our first product. We are mostly an institutionally held stock. We've mostly gone out through the course of our various capital raises to work with high quality institutional fund managers. And I've listed a couple of them there as our major shareholders. And as I said, I think really the key excitement factor for the company this year is that transition to a revenue generating revenue stage company. Next slide, please. So this is your science lesson for the morning. So in a nutshell, what we do is we're a drug company that develops targeted radioactive drugs, or what we call molecularly targeted radiation. Many of you will know that in cancer care, radiation oncology is really a cornerstone of cancer care. The way it's typically delivered today is you go into the basement of a hospital, you lie down in a big machine and you get x-rays shot at you from outside of your body. It's a very effective way to treat cancer, but you can only image what you can target, or you can only target what you can see in a scan, and you can only treat a field of disease. You can't treat a whole body or a fully metastatic patient. What we do instead is we develop drugs where you attach the radiation to the drug and you inject it into your arm, and the molecule carries that radiation around wherever there's a cancer cell and leaves it there. And in some cases, we add a tiny little bit of radiation and we get a diagnostic image, which you can see there on the right-hand side. There's a picture of a thing called a PET scanner, which is a standard bit of kit in a cancer hospital, and you can see the scan next to it. All those bright spots are where the radiation is being localized. And then if we turn up the dose by 1,000 or 10,000 times, then we can deliver therapeutic levels of radiation. And the beauty of this technology is we literally can scan from your toes to your nose, everywhere in the body, find where your cancer is, dial up the radiation, give you a personalized treatment plan that will attack cancer on a metastatic basis. And in fact, in the bottom right-hand corner there, you can actually see this is an image of the therapeutic drug targeting a patient with advanced metastatic prostate cancer. So this is an incredibly personalized and effective way of delivering radiation. And the big disruption here is to move away from the traditional big box radiation oncology to an injectable that's delivered in an outpatient setting as a very efficient modality of delivery. Next slide, please. So this is our pipeline. Again, I think highly differentiated. There really aren't very many companies in our market that have such an extensive and late stage pipeline. We are not developing products in mice anymore. We're in advanced clinical development. We have one product that's already got a marketing authorization on a limited basis in some countries, which we'll be expanding. This is the bottom, the green arrow that we acquired through an acquisition last year. But in terms of the company's first product to market is, as I mentioned before, the prostate imaging agent, Illuccix. And I'll go through a country by country sort of breakdown on where that is. In general, for this pipeline, what you'll note is that the imaging agents are always ahead of the therapeutic programs. And that's because developing imaging agents is a lot more straightforward. You're not treating a patient, you're not modifying a patient's biology. And the clinical trials tend to be a lot simpler. But the point of it is that the imaging also de-risks the pathway to therapy. And in the case of Telix, the prostate and the renal cancer indications have some standalone, very important clinical utility in their own right. And we can make a nice business out of those imaging products as they then pull through the therapy programs later in the pipeline. Moving on to the next slide, please. Just a little bit about our team. So we are a globally active company. Actually, we run clinical trials in about 30 countries around the world. We deliver our products to around 60 countries on a limited basis because they're not yet approved, but we do support compassionate and certain kinds of special access programs. Last year, about 10,000 patients around the world received a Telix product. And the reason why I mention that is because it tells you a lot about the scale that we're operating as a company. This is not an early stage business. We are now working out the global logistics and supply chain for our company. We're a Melbourne headquartered company, although we have regional offices in Sydney and Brisbane, and also international offices in Japan, Belgium, and the United States. We're about 100 people now. Three quarters of our workforce is outside of Australia. You can imagine that's a pretty major requirement right now because of the lack of travel and mobility of the Australian team. And so having a strong and very capable international team has been a big part of our resilience during this difficult time. We have an outstanding board of directors led by Mr. Kevin McCann, who's well known to many of you, the former Macquarie chairman, has been very active on a number of high quality company boards. Jan Skinner, Mark Nelson, again, very well known to some of you in terms of funds management expertise. So really intellectual caliber of the board supporting the management team is really outstanding. And we're very privileged to have such a great support in the team. Next slide, please. So moving on, next slide again, sorry. So the prostate cancer program. So as I mentioned, our flagship program, Illuccix, we filed a submission for approval to the FDA in September of last year, which was accepted. We're currently sort of two-thirds of the way through that review cycle process. We had our mid-cycle review meeting in March where the FDA told us that that we had a clear pathway forward to approval, and we have our next review meeting in the middle of June. We have no major issues that have been raised in our submission, so we're fairly confident that we have a clear pathway to approval. And now the focus of the company, and particularly the US team, as you can imagine, is that scale up and readiness for commercialization. And we've got some extremely strong partners in the US, particularly Cardinal Health, where at the time that we get approval, we'll be ready to activate, very immediately, over 100 nuclear pharmacies ready to go with the ability to reach about 95% of US hospital beds. So a big inflection point for the company. I'll talk more about the market opportunity in a second. Next slide, please. In parallel, we also submitted a European marketing authorization. This went in a few months earlier last year. European submissions are a lot more complicated, as you can imagine, because you've got to contend with all the different member states. But in our first wave of approvals, we're going after 14 European countries. We have a very broad indication that we've submitted for, and we've already started to receive some temporary national authorizations in the meantime. The first one a couple of months ago was the Czech Republic, and you can expect to see over the course of this year additional European countries starting to allow the use of our product in advance of marketing authorization. And the reason that's the case is because we're very fortunate that we are already written into the clinical practice guidelines in the United States and Europe. So even though we don't yet have an approved product, we're already written into clinical practice guidelines as standard of care. And that's a really important benefit. It really gives us a lot of tailwind going into the commercial launch of our product. And you can expect to see by around late Q3 of this year that individual European countries will start to pop out, and there'll be hopefully a flurry of positive news flow around those European product approvals. Next slide, please. And this is just, give you a bit of a sense of the fact that we haven't just stopped in the US and in Europe. We are pursuing, we just got the TGA acceptance for our submission. In fact, we got a priority review in Australia, which means we have a very accelerated review timeline. We have also got a submission accepted in Canada. We have a Swissmedic filing in progress. This is important for a lot of other countries that use Switzerland as a reference, as sort of a reference health authority for their approvals. And we are also active in Asia, not just in China, as I mentioned before, but we also have clinical activity in Japan that's designed to then bridge to our global data set for approval. So I guess the key message here is that, we are committed to rolling out and making our products available globally, and we are building the infrastructure as a business to deliver on that. Next slide, please. So this is just to give you a sense of the market opportunity that we have. It's a very significant opportunity. We've presented in the past some of our analysis on why we think that prostate cancer imaging is important, but the nutshell of it is that across the major indications that we can expect to receive for our product, we see a total addressable market in our major markets, that's Europe and the US, of around $850 million. We do have some competition, but we also have a clear value proposition and a very unique product rollout model. And we're confident that there's a significant proportion of that addressable market that's going to be available to Telix. So, the market opportunity that we're going after with our flagship product, Illuccix, is not a small opportunity. It's a significant opportunity for the company and for our shareholders. Moving on to the next slide, please. And then I mentioned in the beginning that, all of our programs are theranostic or diagnostic and therapeutic. As our prostate imaging product goes to market, we are also finishing the clinical development of our prostate therapy program. So this is a clinical trial called the PROSTAC trial, phase 3 trial in men with metastatic prostate cancer. We're expecting this to start in Australia in the next month or so, and then we'll be gradually adding sites in Europe and the US over the course of the year. This is a very big inflection point for a life sciences company. The vast majority of small biotech companies don't get to run phase 3 trial. We've got very compelling data in over 200 patients that suggests that this drug is efficacious in this setting. And we, through a very detailed consultation with the Food and Drug Administration, we've come up with a clinical trial that we think will demonstrate the utility of this drug in an important patient setting. So very exciting, inflection point for the company in terms of its development as a biotech company. Next slide, please. So moving along, we also have another phase 3 trial running right now. This is a diagnostic phase 3 trial in renal cancer called the Zircon trial. This is a 36 site clinical trial running in about 14 countries around the world. It's a 252 patient study that's expected to finish enrollment around the middle of the year. And then that's our second baked product. Around Q3, we expect to have a top line readout. And then by the end of the year, we'll commence the submission process for what will be our second product. It's a very synergistic product with our first product. It's also a urologic oncology product. It somewhat targets the same customer base. And so the sales and marketing infrastructure that we are building right now for the first product will really support very nicely the second product as well. So, again, I think one of the key messages about Telix, we've got multiple shots on goal. We've got a very well-crafted product portfolio and a very clear game plan for execution on that portfolio. Moving to the next slide, please. We also, just as a side comment, we just received our top line readout from our bridging study in Japan. We were able to show that this technology works in Asian patients just the same way as it does in Caucasian patients, where the genetic profile of the cancer can be a little bit different. We successfully demonstrated that. And so now we have a very fast and clear pathway as well to get approval in Japan and hopefully to move that approval footprint as well into other countries like China and Korea in the near future also. Next slide, please. And then last of all, just like the prostate cancer program, we also have the therapy program for renal cancer. We have two phase two programs that are just about to start in the United States. The first one should be enrolling patients, hopefully subject to the FDA by around the May timeline. These are using targeted radiation in conjunction with immuno-oncology drugs. This is really cutting edge science. And we really expect this to generate some interesting data. So again, just to show that across the pipeline, our products are moving ahead really as a front of activity. Next slide, please. Next slide again. So then our earliest stage program is a program in glioblastoma. I'm just looking at the time here. Is in glioblastoma. This is in the type of aggressive brain cancer. We are also getting some very nice data. We just recently put out our first preliminary results from our initial clinical trial, and we expect to accelerate this program as well over the course of the year. So very hard to treat cancer where we're starting to get some beautiful data. Maybe if I can just jump to the last slide then in the presentation, just in the interest of time. The problem with going first and first thing in the morning. No, continue on, please. I won't go over this. Yep. So just to summarize, the company has three major inflection points for the year, what we call commence, complete, and launch. So we are starting our phase three trial in prostate cancer, a very significant inflection point for the company. We're going to complete our existing phase three trial around the middle of the year in renal cancer, and that will lead to our second product going into a regulatory process. And then last of all, the launch of our flagship prostate cancer imaging program. So a very, very significant year for the company and one that is certainly going to be worth watching from a shareholder perspective.